I'm Terry Murphy, senior editor for Realty Times, Women in Business, Women in Real Estate, and In the Men's Room with Murph. I'm also the senior editor with The Data Advocate. And today we have a fabulous woman in the real estate department, a woman of power. Her name is Marika Abuashvili. Now, I'm not going to have the great Georgian accent that she has, but you are meeting a powerhouse woman, and we are going to be together at the MLS International Forum in Paris this week. I get to meet her in person. She is with the Georgian National Association of Realtors. She's currently an executive board member at the International Chamber of Commerce in Georgia, and that's not in the United States, by the way. At the same time, she chairs the Real Estate Commission at ICC. She's a realtor with over 25 years of experience. Here's the best part about her. Well, not the best. But she lived and worked in Seattle, Washington, USA, and had to go back to Georgia. And this is our brilliant and fragile and amazing and precious connection. Because when we're in Paris at the International Forum, we're going to be discussing on my panel standards. And who understands that better than somebody who's already been there and done that? So welcome, Miss Marika.
Thank you so much for letting me be here. It's a pleasure to meet you, and I'm glad I can participate in this process.
Well, they've got you working a lot. You're going to be on several different panels, but for the one that I'm moderating with you with Zola and Dan Negulescu, I'm not even going to try and say Zola's last name. This is an education on
nobody can
different...
say.
I know, but we are going to be talking about standards because my understanding from working with the two of them that there hasn't been a consistency of standards across Europe, and because you have such beautiful experience here in the U.S. with what we have, which is not a perfect system, but at least a system for multiple listing service. Tell us what you think you're going to be able to share with us on the panel that I'm hosting.
Oh, thank you so much for giving me this opportunity. Yes, definitely. You said it. Maybe the system isn't perfect, but it is a system, and therefore it's better than no system. And I think I was just recently in Nice, meeting a lot of real estate professionals from different countries. And of course, you know, in the United States, we're spoiled. I say it with confidence because comparing to what I see in Georgia and a couple other countries around this Eastern European region, I think that real estate agents are spoiled in the United States with tools that they have to available to them. And those tools work because they are under certain systems, they're under regulations, they're under rules. And that's why this works so well for realtors, and therefore it works for their consumers because realtors then can deliver incredible services to their clients, right? Now, it is not so in Georgia, where I am right now, in country of Georgia. And from what I'm gathering, it is not so in many European countries. And maybe if we will go even east from here, probably the same story happens there. And I think the there's a lot of reasons why not. And we will be probably covering it in details during the forum. But I think that rules and regulations is number one thing. And I'll tell you an interesting story briefly. I don't know how much time I have, but I'll try to be very short. That we are actually pioneering MLS system here in Georgia through our National Association of Realtors here in Georgia. Here's a funny thing. We have a couple of options for technological platforms, but it's not the secret. It's not a secret at all. Because once we have a technological platform, then comes to question who will run it, how they will run it, what we can do, what we cannot do, who can do it, who the information belongs to. And all those questions come up that nobody can answer, right? In the United States, it's all taken care of. We have RESO standards, and it's amazing. And I think it's admirable that the system exists, the standard exists. And I think it would be amazing if future MLSs of Europe, let's say, would adopt those standards, and they would be unifying a lot of different technological platforms and at the same time solving a lot of issues, administrative legislative and so on. So I think we need to learn from the best, and with confidence again, I'll say that from my experience, at least from my observation, what we have in the United States, MLS system that works, and this whole ethic and discipline, it is the best so far, from what I know.
Yes, we are going to bring together the minds across, the minds and experiences and visions of many countries and many experts. You know, it's the glitterati of the real estate industry that's able to attend. Very exciting to see how people embrace this opportunity. But you're also going to be on another panel with the lovely Gisela Badi, and we've already interviewed her on Realty Times and on the Data Advocate, the ecosystems of real estate in countries around the world. Tell us a little slight overview of what's going to be addressed there.
No, I'm sorry, Terry, I didn't hear the last part of the question. I apologize. The voice disappeared. Sorry about that.
Tell us a little bit about the presentation you're going to be doing for the ecosystems of real estate in countries around the world with Gisela Badi.
Sure. At least the way I imagine it will be, it is a first experience for me as well to participate in event of such magnitude and importance and so dear to my heart. But from what I understand, we will be talking and comparing different experiences across the board, like we just did briefly here, right? So I talked a little bit about Georgia, and we compared it to what happens in America. So I think that's what we'll be sharing, and there will be representatives from other countries as well who will probably contribute their experiences, and that's what we will talk about. As far as MLS goes, I think we probably will be discussing what works and what doesn't, and if it doesn't work, why doesn't it work, and what can we do to make it work?
Well, you say, given the cultural diversity across European countries, it's going to be more than just standards and technology and data, but training and engaging people into the benefits of MLS. So I'm really looking forward to meeting you in person in Paris in just a few days. You're going to be a tremendous asset, not just to that panel, into that program, but to women in real estate across the universe, because that's what we do. So thank you so much for joining us today, and travel safely. And I'm looking forward to sharing what your presentation is going to be after the event as well. I hope you'll join us again for another interview.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Terry. Very nice meeting you today. And thank you for having me here today.